going, my friend. Today's video is going to be about the Wrong Car Saga. I'm going to be making a tier list. I do hope you're going to enjoy this video. And with that being said, like, if you like this video, like, comment, and subscribe. Yeah, got a community post. So, about. Alright, so let me just hop right into this. So, I'm just going to get the pretty obvious ones out the way. Kamimura is not going into C tier. Jesus Christ, no. So, our boy Yamamoto is going to go in A+ here. Where's our boy Don Guy Ichigo? Alright, so we're going to have the Aizens. The Aizens are going to be... I don't know if I'll say, like, controversial, but it's just how high they're going to be. All the Aizens, actually. And I'm not being dumb. Is that all the Aizens? Oh, there's Mugetsu. And Don Guy Ichigo. Ooh. Very nice, very nice, very nice. I think that's all. So let me just slap them up here. Our boys, Don Guy Ichigo, Mugetsu. Then, yes sir. Is there not a Monster Aizen in Bleach Brave Souls? There's not a Monster Aizen. Okay, so we don't have Monster Aizen. Okay, that's pretty sad. All right, but it has to be like this. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. So the reason that Aizen and his higher fusions are in A+ tier, but Yamamoto is only in A tier, is because with Aizen's first fusion, he gets so powerful that even Ichigo himself just directly concedes. So the reason this is very important is because Ichigo beforehand had fought Ukiura, who was bare minimum 1,000 times more powerful than him. 100 times more powerful or 1,000 times more powerful. Bare minimum, right? Bare minimum. And he didn't. Like, he didn't concede at all. But against Aizen, he literally just lost the will to fight. So the difference in power between just base Aizen and Chrysalis Aizen, he's actually insane. We also kind of see this with his fight against Isshin, Kisuke, and Yorichi, because they're not actually able to damage him unless he himself allows him to be damaged. We get this statement when he's contemplating and understanding Mugetsu's powers. If he didn't purposely lower his spiritual pressure, none of them could have even damaged him or affected him. So, absurd difference in power, as well as Aizen himself. Every time he does get damaged at all, he literally is like aware of it. Like, he literally noticed it beforehand, and then like he lets himself get damaged, or he literally just sees it and like, no, not gonna happen. Our boy Sajin Kamimura, pretty easy. Well, like this, our boy Kamimura 1-0. Well, he was doing pretty good against his first resurrection, but then second resurrection, and then he won a whole lot of ass whooping. So that seems pretty fair. So, this is the Espada Plus tier. B, where's our boy Yami? Where are you, Yami? I'm stupid. Move to the side! Move to the side! Okay. Kenpachi. Where's our boy, Byakuya? I feel like this is going to be a boring video because I didn't just start off having it finished. So this might be a boring video. And if it is, I'm sorry. I do apologize. Try my best, you know. Boy Ukiura. Boy Noitora. Baragon. Hollybell. Where's our boy Stark? Stark is somewhere here. Noitora didn't go up. Where is Stark? There's Stark. Our homie Stark. Easy peasy blends. Squeezy. Alright. So, I'll use this Ichigo as the Ichigo after he fully holifies. Like, even though this is his fight with Grimmjow, I'm just going to use this Ichigo as meaning after full hollow Ichigo. That's the Ichigo I'm just going to be using. So, basically just FKT Ichigo. That Ichigo is right here. Boop. Very powerful. The reason full hollow Ichigo is above Yami, well, the reason it's like this is because Yami is relative to full hollow Ichigo in his first resurrection, and then he has his rage mode boost, and he's 10 times more powerful, so I'll ratchet over here. And then Bodegon, Bali Bell, and Stark doesn't want to move over, but you're moving over anyway. Then we have our boy Noitora, and the reason they're in the same tier is because we don't actually have a power difference between Ukiora and Noitora, and there's arguments to be made about the difference not being that big. So that's the reason they're in the same tier, or should be in the same ballpark, like, anyway, so. Where is our boy Wonder Rice? Wonder Rice is not going in D tier, no. Wonder Rice is not going in D tier, buddy. Wonder Rice is going right up here. He's going in that A tier. And with them, let me get the visors up here. Mashiro and Kensei, they're right with our boy, our homie, our friend. Thunderbice. But they're actually going to be at the very end of it. So, Mashiro actually damages Kensei. Kensei, Jesus Christ, no. Mashiro actually damages Wonder Weiss and does pretty good. Then her mask breaks. Then Kensei fights him. So, the reason I have Mashiro above him is because the only time she's actually, like, struggling or getting damaged by Wonder Weiss is once her mask breaks, which obviously isn't her full strength. Kensei is fighting Wonder Weiss, but, you know, Kensei doesn't use his mask. I don't know if he uses his mask. So, just based on the things we see, Mashiro should be above. But if he can use his mask, and he does just use his mask, it's probably like this. So, I'll just put it right there for the possibility. And I hate that that banner keeps on showing. Very mad hours. Obviously, this goes like this. Sadly enough, well, no. I'm actually going to put it like this. Because Holly Bell would lose the fight. But let's say out of 5 fights, Holly Bell would win more fights than Toshiro. Because Toshiro wins because Holly Bell specifically wanted to end it in one shot. That's the specific reasoning they give for it. Because Holly Bell was dogging Toshiro in her base. And then she starts doing worse when she goes into Resurrection. And then there's an explanation, oh, trying to finish this off in one strike. So that's pretty much it. Yorichi, right up here. Godkin Ishin up here. Kisuke. So Ishin does the most damage to Aizen. He's the one that pushes him in the first place, so he's right there. Kisuke is actually equal to Aizen. So I guess it would be more fair to put it like this. Because Ishin is more powerful than Aizen. Kisuke is equal to Aizen. And Yoruichi, well, she fights. She boxes up Aizen. So it's very ambiguous who's actually stronger. They're obviously relative, but who's actually stronger between Kisuke and Yoruichi? That's the real question. So, where is our boy? Missing somebody. Where's our boy Gin? Is Gin not here? What do you mean? No. Oh, I'm stupid. Okay. I was going to start mourning the loss of Gin already. No. Our homie right here. So, Gin's here because he skills to Ichigo. Base Ichigo, pretty good, honestly. Hollowfied Ichigo, skills to Aizen. He's stronger than Aizen. Gin actually states that Ichigo was on Aizen's level. And Aizen actually is also like, dude, you're weaker than you're supposed to be. This is because of Ichigo's current mind state at the moment. He's mentally nerfed, which is the reason why he doesn't straight up just cut Yami in half like Kenpachi was doing to Yami. Because just going by feats, this man just lops like Yami's leg off, then gets hit by Yami and actually takes damage. Ichigo doesn't even take any damage. Like, he's attacked by Yami multiple times. He can block Yami, and then he's able to damage Yami. So it's literally just as he's mentally nerfed currently. It's actually also commented on by Rukia. So that's the reason he's right here. This is supposed to be FKT. So fully healed, mask. But just, you know what? You know what? Right here. That is Ichigo at half power. This is like regular Bankai Ichigo, but this is Ichigo at half power, right? That's the Ichigo that's supposed to represent, okay? So should be pretty easy. We get to Aizen. Then the other Aizens. I think this is like pretty easily explainable. Wonder Ice only has scaling above all of the Espada. He doesn't have any scaling to like pass that, Konami has a second Resurrection on top of it. Because Wonder Rice really only sells to somewhere near Yamamoto. But like, he's not really relative to Yamamoto at all. Like, what I mean by not really relative is that he is relative, but it's a very low end. Because he continuously bombards Yamamoto with his attacks, and he's barely able to do any damage. So, yeah, sure. But it should be that these guys should be stronger. Alright. Then it's just the people that skill to the Espada. We got the Visors right here. Boy Love and Rose. We have our boy, our girl Lisa. I was going to say our boy Lisa. We have Snaggletooth Hiyori. Man, Hiyori seemed to be the leader. Our boy Hachi. Are you serious? Come on. Let me drop Hachi right here. The boy Hachi. They would have lost. Hachi and Soifone would have lost, which is why Bar got above them. They, Holly Bell can literally foe Toshiro if needed. Stark literally wins next these two. Where's Shunsui? Shunsui has to pull rat tactics. They do go full power against each other, but Stark is like, he did continuously like split his soul, then got like off guarded multiple times. So Stark didn't have his best performance, and Stark also was casually winning. So Stark would have just won and wouldn't let him get the chance right here. Pretty easy. And I think that's all for the relevant people. I'm sorry that I disrespected you like that. Our boy Jushiro. I'm sorry. Oh, no. I disrespected Jushiro with that one. Oh, I feel bad. But this is pretty easy. This is basically all the relevant characters. Yeah, I'm calling all the rest of these niggas irrelevant. Retsu is above, like, up. At least here. That's how strong Retsu is. Bearman. Alright. So, Shuhei's in D tier. That Kaname feat is him off guard. No feats. Ew, no feats. You know? These guys are pretty trash. We have Zomari here. Zomari isn't pretty high. Mayuri. Psylopro. Arniero. God King Grimjaw. Rukia. Beats Arniero. Arniero clearly had the upper hand down, so above in the tier list. Psylopro loses to Mayuri. Easy. Zomari, not that good. Number 8 is Espada, fights Byakuya, but there are multiple arguments for Byakuya suppressing himself or just getting stronger. So Zomari does not, I would say Zomari is not going up here. Not right there. Zomari is down here. Zomari is a bum. Alright. He kicks rocks. Grimmjow, no, numbers higher. Pretty easy. These guys are pretty weak. So, yeah. These guys fight this man. They didn't beat him though. I'll go right here. That's pretty good, you know. Ew. Rangiku wasn't ill, but this is just like lieutenant-ish, captain-ish. Like, these guys are lieutenant but captain tier. Lieutenant but captain tier. He's pretty weak. It's like Fraction though. Lieutenant but like captain tier. Nemu with the boy. Standard equipment. But Nemu's going behind. Because Nemu literally just got neg. Random fodder. Actual just bozos. Bozo. Chad's a bozo as well. We're sorry. Chad's a bozo. Ew. Trash. Loopy. Doesn't scale to anybody. Scales to our boy Toshiro. Toshiro gets more training, gets stronger. One shot by Grimmjow. Nowhere. Shinji. Right above Grimmjow. Pretty easy. Actually, no. Oh my god. Shinji scales like above Grimmjow, but that's with one arm and in base. Grimmjow has a resurrection. Shinji said, I'm going all out, and he uses his mask. Grimmjow would dog Shinji. Because Shinji's only other scaling is to Aizen. And he was under Kyokai Suigetsu. So Shinji actually has no feats. So that's actually depressing. If you want to say, oh, he's the leader. Like, he's the leaderist figure. And so he's above, like, all these guys. So he's all the way up here in, like, B tier. No. Just because, like, you're the leader doesn't make you stronger. So, yep. This is the fine tier list. Powerful tier list. This is what I like to see. This is what I like to see. This might be a little different from the tier list I showed a few months ago. I'm not actually sure if it is or not. But, yeah. I'm going to be making a video as well on the Espada. So, the Espada, like, are a lot more relative than people give them credit for. So, yeah. I'm going to be leaving this right here. This is like the full tier list. Let me just save this. Yeah, what I'm using right now is very slow, so I'm sorry. Alright. Yeah, look how slow this is. I'm very sad. I can't be making this. But yeah, with that being said, I do hope you enjoyed this video. I did enjoy making this. Pretty casual video. Pretty casual. Hope you have a wonderful day. I'm out. Bye-bye.
The key to love is also loving yourself. Now, and love is a very complicated thing. Look at love like a game. Everything is a game. Look at love like a game. If, in order for your partner to respect you, you have to respect yourself. But in the same context, you also have to compromise for them. So it's a very complicated idea. I was disappointed because obviously no one will be able to compromise for me fully because I would give my all and put my all into things. And I would just never be compensated for the love I would give. So, as far as compromise, for one, don't put your pride in the fucking relationship. The shit doesn't work. It makes the shit harder than it needs to be. It makes it complicated. It makes everything hard. Do not put your ego in a relationship. Do not be afraid to blow up your lover's phone. It's the ones that are annoying that love you. It's the ones that will sit there and blow you up for hours and check on you 24/7 and annoy the fuck out of you that care. It's okay to be annoying. Don't try and publicize. I'd say publicize your love in the same context, like show people you're happy. But when you start showing people what you've got going on in your personal life, that's when people feel the need to get involved or people get in the middle and fuck everything up. Keep your relationship to yourself.